So in this video, I'll show you how to use Zebra Designer to connect it to a data source. So in this sample, I'll show an Excel as a database source. So you connect it to this source and how to import the variable data to print across multiple labels. Okay, so let's start. So before we start, I'll show you the Excel file that we are going to connect. So this is how the sample database we are going to use for this session. So we have some basic fields, name, employee number, weight, age, and date, and then the blank group kind of a field that we have. So typically you will be using multiple fields. You can run into thousands of records on the file. So here, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. Sheet 2, sheet 3 are all blank. All we have, the data is only on the sheet 1. Okay, so let me close it. So before you connect it to any data source, make sure the data source is closed. So let me open the design. So I've created a 4x6 label layout and the printer, everything is set up. So I think the previous video enough has been told about setting up the label designer. So let's straight away go to how to see the database get connected to a record. Okay. So here you have this data field on top. Okay. So click that data. So you have multiple database connection options. So either you can connect to an Excel data sales source or Access data source, or even you can connect to a text file. So remember, this can be done with a professional version only, which is licensed. Okay, not with an essential. You cannot do with the essential part. So now Excel's text file, or if you have ODBC connected data source, you can connect and then get an data from any of the ODBC data source like SQL or Oracle also. Okay, so now for this video, I'll click Excel part. So then the wizard will pop up. So here just the step-by-step database wizard comes on. So click next and it is asking for the file where the data source is located. So I click browse. I have stored this on my desktop training folder. Open it, and this is the name of the file that I just showed. So click it. So here you have the option advanced setup or test connection. Test connection is to just make sure the connectivity part is all through. So if at all, if this file is located in a network folder or a shared folder, you can always do the test connection part. So I'll show you the advanced setup part. What is it all about? So here, if the file has any username, password, access password, that can be set over here. Okay, so the blank password, just remove it, allow saving password, and type in the password that can be used to access this file. Okay, so anyway, this is the local file, so as of now, I don't have any access restriction on this file. Okay, so this is how you do it over here. So click next. So now it has auto-populated the fields that the Excel file is having. So you can see the name, employee number, weight, age, date, what all the columns that I showed on the Excel file, all are here. So if you don't want any of the column, you can select that part. So I don't want the date column to be there, then just select that one and say remove. So that will be under the removed field. So these are only the selected field. Okay. So I want everything to be added. So I just say add all. Now say next. So this is the option that you want, how you want the data to be collected and printed by this design. Okay, so now the first option is fixed number of printed labels, or the number of printed labels defined by a field in the database. So let's say you want to print this database, the entire data, and you want to define some quantity for each of the records. If that is the case, one of the column can have the number of labels for each record. So let's say the first field should only print for one label, the second field should print 5 labels, or the third field should print no labels, so you can put a 0 from that column. So one column in the Excel file, Excel sheet, should have a information on the number of labels you want to print for that particular record. So here I don't define that part. So you can go for fixed number of printed labels. So if you don't want that and you just want one record to be printed for all print job, you can just select one record and you say 10 labels, one same information will be printed across all the labels. So for us, The right option here is fixed number of printed labels. The second option, I don't have a column defined for printing the number of labels for each record. So if you have that, you can select this, and you have to select what is the column that is having the number of labels for records. Okay, so we don't have that particular column here, so that's why I've selected the first one. Okay, so next. So create a label text object for each field, or do not create any label object. So if you have selected this, then all the columns that you saw, the name, the age, the birth, the date, everything will be populated into the design. So I don't want that option, because I will choose which record I should have on my design. Okay, so I say do not create any label objects. Say next. So it is populating all the records. So what all records you have on the Excel file is now listed here. So these are the records that is there. So you can, it is just to have a cross check. And you have the option to do filtering. So you can create filter, add condition, and say what condition for each thing should be there so that the print can happen. All those things can be done on the filter part. The same way you have on the sorting, and if you have SQL, you can have the SQL fields to mix and match or put a criteria on what basis the label should be printed. All those things can be done. So coming back to data, so these are the data source, the data fields that we have on our Excel database. Okay, so up to 1000 rows will be shown in this preview. So more than that, it will be printing but will not be shown in the preview area. So now that is the last of the database connection wizard. We can say finish. Okay, so it's all done. Our database is connected. So because we selected not to populate all the objects, nothing is populated here. So now how to get the data to be incorporated into our design. Okay, so now I click text, and I to make it more relevant, what I say is I say employee name. Okay, so that is one field. So let it be here. To make it more appealing, we'll create one more text and put a colon mark. Okay, so that colon mark is over here. Okay, just position the colon mark in the right area. So let me just resize that because it is so small. So for you to adjust the position of the text, you can always press Control and then use the up and right arrow keys, up, down, or right arrow keys, so that the micro positioning can be done. Okay, so now one text field and one thing has been added. So I just add one more thing. So to make it easy, I just selected that option, selected those fields by using the mouse and then clicking and dragging it so that all the fields are copied. I just say Control C to copy and then do a Control V. So it is pasted again. So what I do here is I take the age field here. Huh? So let us change that to age. So one is employee name, the other one is age. So I just created two fields to save time. So now we have to import the data from the Excel data source. Okay, so now let's create one more text field here. I click, so let us position it correctly. Okay, so now I double click this field. Now we have this option on the data, right? Fixed data, which is where the text is shown here. So instead of fixed data, click that. So you have this drop down option. So databases book1.xls is our Excel file name, and then the sheet one has the name. Okay, so the data fields. So now we want the name, employee name should come in the name field, right? So that is where all the names are listed on the name column. So I select the name. So that's the multiple option comes in. So the first database value is shown here. The name is shown here for you to see. So you can all the I have the option of a limited link, because some names could be extended names and all, right? So it should not go on further and further. So you can limit how many characters should be there in this particular field. So I just say 24 is the maximum it should be having on this particular column, right? So I'm limited the number of characters to 24. Say close, apply and close. So that is the name field where it is going to come. And then age also I want to come and auto populate. So again, you create one more text field. So the age is going to come here. Let us position it correctly. And then I double click it. So again, the same way, you drop it. So you don't want the fixed data. Let's take the data from the. So this is our age column where the age will get auto populated. So again, here age is not going to be more than 3 characters. We can put a 3 here. Apply and close. Right. So that is where it is selected. And if you want another field, I can have a barcode, and then we can make the barcode also as a variable field here. Huh? So we'll just select here barcode, and let us have the date field as a barcode value. Okay. So here I just double clicked it. So sorry for making it so fast. So this is your barcode. I'm just double clicking it to get the wizard of the particular barcode. So here I just drop it down, and we'll select the date for the barcode as a value. Okay, so this is where the, and you can select how the barcode data format should be, the date format should be. So I just want only the hour, month, date, and year. So that format it is going to show it here. So apply, close. So we have 3 fields being taken from our Excel source. So this likewise, you can add multiple fields and then see how. I mean, you can design as and when as and thing that what you have as a requirement. Okay. So now for you to see how this is working, we'll just go to File, Print, and you can see the fields getting populated here. So let's. So let's not select all the thing. So I'll select one data here, and you can see that particular name field occupying here. So let us select one more data. So that is what it is going to print. So it picks up these data. So all you have to do is select what all records you want to print, and say print. All these records will get printed automatically for each label. Okay. So this is how it will get printed. So, hope it is clear. Thanks. Thanks for watching the video.